Metamorphosis. Metamorphosis is a biological process by which an animal physically develops after birth or hatching, involving a conspicuous and relatively abrupt change in the animal's body structure through cell growth and differentiation. All insects in the pterygota undergo a marked change in form, texture, and physical appearance from immature to adult. These insects either have hemimetabolous development, that is an incomplete or partial metamorphosis, or a holometabolous development, which undergo a complete metamorphosis, including a pupal or resting stage between the larval and adult forms. In hemimetabolous insects, immature stages are called nymphs. Development proceeds in repeated stages of growth and ecdysis, that is, molting. These stages are called instars. The juvenile forms closely resemble adults, but are smaller and lack adult features such as wings and the genitalia. This process is known as partial or incomplete metamorphosis. The differences between nymphs in different instars are small, often just differences in body proportions and the number of segments, although external wing buds will form in later instars. In holometabolous insects, immature stages are called larvae and differ markedly from adults. Insects which undergo holometabolism pass through a larval stage, then enter an inactive state called pupa or chrysalis and finally emerge as adults. This process is called complete metamorphosis. It is theorized that the pupal stage is the evolutionary compaction of all the nymphal stages of their hemimetabolous ancestors, while the larval stage is an extended mobile form of the developing embryo. According to recent research, adult Manduca sexta is able to retain the behavior learned as a caterpillar. Another caterpillar, the ornate moth caterpillar, is able to carry toxins that it acquires from its diet through metamorphosis and into adulthood, where the toxins still serve for protection against predators. Many observations have indicated that programmed cell death plays a considerable role during physiological processes of multicellular organisms, particularly during embryogenesis and metamorphosis. There are two main types of metamorphosis in insects: simple metamorphosis or hemimetabolism and complete metamorphosis or holometabolism. Let us now in detail look at simple metamorphosis or hemimetabolism, also known as incomplete metamorphosis. The group of the insects undergoing this type of metamorphosis is also called the hemimetabola. Insects under this type complete their post-embryonic development without assuming much striking morphological changes. There are three stages in the life of these insects, which are the egg, the nymph, and the adult. The young ones on hatching from eggs are called nymphs. These nymphs resemble their parents very much in their structure of body, whether it is mouthparts, simple and compoundized antenna, legs, etc., show a marked similarity. Similarly, they have the same mode of life, feeding habits, food and habitat. The difference between the nymphs and adults is that the nymphs do not possess wings and the reproductive organs until they turn into a full-grown adults. Besides, nymphs are smaller in size and shape. The wings develop gradually from a small wing pads in the nymphs to a fully developed functional wings in matured adults. This type of metamorphosis is therefore also called gradual metamorphosis. These wings' development takes place externally, and hence this group of insect is called the Exopterygota. The nymphs grow in size and shape, and the successive nymphs grow in size and shape by the process of molting, and the successive instars look more alike to adults. There is no resting or transitional phase for the transformation into adults. Example: dragonflies, damselflies, grasshoppers, cockroach, crickets, aphids, jacids, bugs, etc. The degree of metamorphosis is not the same in all Exopterygota. A few insects like the white flies and thrips on their developmental period pass through a stage called incipient or false pupal stage, comparable to pupa of the Holer Metabola, before emerging as an adult. Such deviation from hemimetabola is called aberrant hemimetabola. In few Exopterygota insects, the wings may be lost or may not develop at all. For example, head louse. But there are rudiments of wings in the form of wing pad buds in these insects, and hence these insects are called secondarily wingless insects. In dragonflies, the nymphs are aquatic while the adults are aerial, and therefore this group is called the hemimetabola. Insects which go through simple or incomplete metamorphosis have three life stages. These insects start as eggs, which are usually very small. When the egg hatches, a larva or nymph comes out. Nymphs are just baby insects. Most of the time, the nymph looks similar to the adult, but it is smaller, may have different coloration, and does not have wings. The nymph grows through stages called instars, shedding its skin, which is the epicuticle, at each stage called the ecdysis. Finally, it changes into a mature adult with wings. Some insect nymphs are aquatic, which means they live in water. These nymphs usually have gills and look very different from the adults they will turn into. Nymphs that live in water are called naiads. Complete metamorphosis or holometabolism. The group of insects undergoing this type of metamorphosis is called the holometabola. The insects in this type complete their post-embryonic development by assuming much striking morphological changes. In order to attain maturity, this insect passes through four different stages, that is, the egg, the larva, the pupa, and adult. Since there are many changes in form, it is called complex metamorphosis. Young one after hatching from the egg is called larva. The larva differs from its parents in the structure, food, feeding habits, mode of life, and habitat. The larva may have biting type of mouth parts, while adults may have different mouth parts such as siphoning type. Similarly, they do not have compound eyes but possesses simple ocelli. Legs are also subjected to compound modifications. Some of the larvae have only three pairs of thoracic legs, the beetles and the weevils, while in others there may be one or more pairs of abdominal legs in addition to thoracic legs, that is, in butterflies and moths. In some larvae, legs are altogether absent in flies. There are several instars during larval stage. There are no external signs of presence of wing pads or buds on the larva. However, these pads are present inside the body cavity in the thoracic region. These wing pads develop internally, hence this group of insects is called Endopterygota. Further, for transformation into adults, the larva has to pass through a resisting phase or the transitional phase called the pupa. feeding and movement ceases and metabolic activities are lower down during the pupal stage, but conspicuous changes in morphological forms in the development of wings and reproductive organs occur in the pupal stage. The adult come out with the pupil covering with development of compound eyes, antenna, thoracic legs, wings, reproductive organs and changes in mouth parts. Since a pupal stage is necessary for the transformation of larva into adult, this type of metamorphosis is called indirect or complete metamorphosis. As endopterygota insects are included under this type of metamorphosis, example butterflies, moth, beetle, weevils, flies, honeybees, wasps, mosquitoes, etc. Insects that have complete metamorphosis have four life stages. These insects start as eggs which are very small. The egg hatches and a larva comes out. The larva looks like a worm and eats so that it can grow much bigger. When the larva has grown, it changes into a pupa. The pupa usually cannot move or eat. The pupa is a special time when the insect is changing into an adult that will look very different from the larva or the pupa. Moth pupa are inside cocoons. When pupa opens, the adult insect comes out. Many insects have a life cycle of egg, larva, pupa, adult. Some of these insects are from the Coleoptera, the beetles, from Hymenoptera, bees, wasps, ants and sawflies, from Lepidoptera, butterflies and moths, and from the Diptera, the flies. The monarch butterfly goes through four stages of development. Life for a monarch butterfly begins as an egg hatched from an adult. This egg then develops into a worm-like larva caterpillar. In the pupa or the chrysalis stage, the caterpillar spins a silk pad on the twig or leaves and hangs from this pad by its large pair of prolegs. It hangs upside down in the shape of a J and then molts, leaving it encased in the green exoskeleton. The mature butterfly emerges after about 2 weeks and feeds on a variety of flowers including milkweed flowers, red clover and goldenrod. Let us now look at the need for metamorphosis. The need for metamorphosis is clear when the relative size of the eggs and adults is understood. A mature Atlantic cod can reach 2 meters long and weigh over 200 pounds. The female will produce over 1 lakh eggs in a single spawning and the resulting larvae are quite tiny. There is no way they could live like the adults, which are more or less top predators. The larva cannot even swim against the current. Therefore, they must live a different kind of life before they can live as adults do. Their development is packaged into stages and each stage has adaptations to life at its stage. The sharp distinction between stages best seen in insects is presumably because a longer transition would leave the juvenile less fit either at its younger or older ways of life. Hypermetamorphosis. Hypermetamorphosis, as the term normally is used in entomology, refers to a class of holometabolism. In hypermetamorphosis, some larval instars functionally and morphologically are distinct from each other. In a typically holometabolic insect, such as most flies, moths or wasps, all the larval instars are similar except that earlier instars are smaller than the later instars. In an insect that undergoes hypermetamorphosis, however, at least one instar usually differs in form and in function as well. Such hypermetamorphosis occurs in very similar forms in several orders of insects and it is appropriate to avoid careless generalizations about the nature of the class of development strategy because biologically speaking, most of the examples are not homologous but analogous. For instance, examples of hypermetamorphosis in the diphtheria are neither derived from examples among the mantispidae nor from any common ancestor with hypermetamorphosis. There are, however, important functional points of resemblance. There are also examples of holometabolic species in which there are certain striking differences between the earliest instars and the later instars, though without their generally being regarded as hypermetamorphic. For example, early instars of many Papilionidae are of a color, shape and texture that suggest bird droppings. Later instars that are larger and would simply stand out in such camouflage typically become leaf green. In hypermetamorphic species, the tendency is to produce the first instar in large numbers as tiny, very mobile larvae that must find their own way to food they will need for their entire larval existence. The general term for such a mobile first instar is planidium, from the Greek language planos, meaning roaming. The planidial instar is specialized for active mobility and is equipped to seek out the prey or host on which subsequent instars are to feed. In typical examples, the first instar larval morphology is campodiform, meaning elongated, flattened and active, more or less resembling the morphology of insects in the genus Campodia. There is, however, considerable variety in the forms of planidia that occur in various families and orders. In the beetle family, Meloidae, the three-clawed planidium originally was called a triangulin, and similar planidia, for example, those of the Strepsiptera may also be called triangula. In the planidial form, many species do not feed. They first change their skin and change their bodily form to a form suited to eating rather than seeking out food. Whether the larva feeds in its phase as a planidium or not, it must feed after it undergoes ichthyosis. In its feeding phase, it adopts a scarabeary form, grub-like or a vermiform, maggot-like morphology. As a rule, the instars after the first ichthyosis are of more or less constant form and not highly mobile, being specialized for feeding and growth until the final larval instar metamorphosis into the pupal form. Various forms of hypermetamorphosis. Hypermetamorphosis usually occurs as an adaptation of the ontogeny of certain parasitoid insects, notably the beetle families Meloidae and the Rhyphoridae, the order Strepsiptera. Flies in the families Acrocidilae, Bombylidae, the Neuropterin family Mantispidae, and the parasitic wasp family Eukaryidae. Technically, the sub-imago of the Ephemeroptera might be described as a stage in a form of hypermetamorphosis, but that is not a common practice. Hormonal control. Insect growth and metamorphosis are controlled by hormones synthesized by endocrine glands near the front of the body. Neurosecretory cells in an insect's brain secrete a hormone, the prothoraciotropic hormone, which is in short called the PTTH, that activates the prothoracic glands, which secrete a second hormone, usually a ecdysone, which is an ecdysteroid that includes ecdysis. PTTH also stimulates the corpora alata, a retrocerebral organ, to produce juvenile hormone, which in short is called as JH, which prevents the development of adult characteristics during ichthyosis. In holometabolous insects, molts between larval insects have a high level of juvenile hormone. The molt to the pupal stage has a low level of the juvenile hormone, and final or the imaginal molt has no juvenile hormone present at all. Experiments on firebugs have shown how juvenile hormone can affect the number of nymph and star stages in hemimetabolism insects. Let us now look at metamorphosis in silkworms. The silkworm life cycle consists of four stages and is considered one of the most advanced forms of metamorphosis. Silkworm undergoes complete metamorphism, in which there is development of the embryo, which is the ova, larva, pupa and the imago. Egg is the first stage of the silkworm life cycle. The female moth lays an egg about the size of an ink dot during summer or the early fall. The egg remains in dormant stage until spring arrives. The warmth of the spring stimulates the egg to hatch. The silkworm upon hatching is about 1/8 of an inch and extremely hairy. Young silkworms can only feed on tender mulberry leaves. However, during the growth phase, they can eat tougher mulberry leaves as well. The larval stage lasts for about 27 days and the silkworm goes through 5 growth stages called instars during this time. During the first molting, the silkworm sheds all its hair and gains a smooth skin. Cocoon is the stage in which the larva spins silk threads around it to protect itself from its predators. The larva traps itself inside the cocoon in order to pupate. The color of the cocoon varies depending upon what the silkworm eats. It can range from white to golden yellow. The second molting occurs inside the cocoon when the larva turns into a brown pupa. It takes about 2 to 3 weeks for the pupa to metamorphose into an adult moth. Once the adult moth comes out of its cocoon, its only purpose is to find a member of the opposite sex and mate. Males are larger than females and are more active. They flap their wings rapidly to attract females. Within 24 hours of mating, the male moth dies, while the female lays abundant eggs, after which she dies as well. Thereon, a new life cycle begins. Eggs take about 10 days to hatch. Silkworms feed day and night on mulberry. When the color of their heads turn darker, it means this is the time for them to molt. Later, instars are white, nude and have a horn on the back. After they have molted 4 times, that is, in the 5th instar, their bodies turn slightly yellow and their skin become tighter. The larvae enclose themselves in a cocoon of raw silk produced in the salivary glands that provide protection during the vulnerable, almost motionless pupal. If the animal is allowed to survive after spinning its cocoon, it will release proteolytic enzymes to make a hole in the cocoon so that it can emerge as a moth. This would cut short the threads and ruin the silk. Instead, silkworm cocoons are boiled. The heat kills the silkworm and the water makes the cocoon easier to unravel. The adult phase, the moth cannot fly. The silk moth have a wingspan of 3 to 5 cm and a white hairy body. Females have about twice to 3 times the bulk of males for their carrying more eggs, but are similarly colored. With this, we come to the end of the chapter Metamorphosis. Thank you.